Hello everyone. In this video, we're going to look at Niti Aayog, National Institution for Transforming India. You all know the facts, who launched it, when it was launched, so I'll skip those. The Governing Council of Niti Aayog comprises the state chief ministers and lieutenant governors of the union territories, the regional councils to address specific issues and contingencies impacting more than one state or a region, and a full-time organizational framework headed by the prime minister. So what's the difference between Planning Commission and Niti Aayog? First of all, Planning Commission had a more of a top-down approach for planning. So they said that, okay, we know what is best for the country and we will decide that, okay, let us say the priority is drinking water. So you do drinking water. So every state in the country focuses on drinking water. But Niti Aayog says that we're going to formulate a national developmental strategy in an integrated market economy. So they say that in this world today, we are all interlinked. So when we're interlinked with the world, obviously India itself has to be interlinked. And when we're all interlinked, the development of the country needs to be integrated as well. And for that, we need to formulate a strategy which will be done by the central coordinating agency called Niti Aayog. The Planning Commission used to set growth targets, goals and strategies. But like this is more to propound on the same fact, the same point a little bit more. So this is more about evolving a national developmental strategy in consultation with the states. The Planning Commission was fundamentally a central government institution without much state representation. But Niti Aayog is basically propounding the idea of partnership. So it's not just consultations. Wherein, see, what is a consultant? A consultant is someone who comes in at a particular stage, gives his ideas and then leaves. So he is not exactly your partner in what you're going through. So in this case, Niti Aayog, more than just a consultation with the states, wants to partner with the state governments to promote cooperative federalism. Because they feel that till the economic federalism is really in place, there is no point in having a federalism in the polity. Federalism just means the a dual structure of two governments, basically. So, but does this mean that the states are left on their own and they will not get any support? That is definitely not true. Niti Aayog will continue to give support to the states for removing bottlenecks and impediments. They will also be able to oppose the new institution for consultancy and capacity building. So whatever problems they face in implementing a particular plan, so Niti Aayog in that role will act as a consultant. So they will do handholding on the states and help them remove the bottlenecks. Till now, Planning Commission was more of a central body which used to tell the states what they have to do. But if the states faced problems, it was basically their problem. And the Planning Commission did not get too much involved in why the state is not able to achieve what they are not able to achieve. But Niti Aayog is going to change that and have more scope for handholding. Okay, in terms of the allocations, the allocation of central assistance to state plans in the budget of 2014-15 was approximately 59%. So 44% under centrally sponsored schemes and 15% under block grants. So what does this mean? This means that a lot of money was being given by the Planning Commission in centrally sponsored schemes. But the problem with this was that they were not really tailorable to the needs of the state and they had very set guidelines. So which meant that the states could not tailor the development according to their own needs. So there was somebody telling them that this is how you should do your development, but there was no elbow space for the states to maneuver. But in case of Niti Aayog, they say that the states will tailor their plans to suit their needs, and there will still be centrally sponsored schemes, more than 40, but they will have greater flexibility for state specific needs. So even now, we did have some provisions for state-specific needs, but it is going to increase much more with the coming of Niti Aayog. In case of a structure, Planning Commission was headed by a Prime Minister with a politician or economist as Deputy Chairman and the union and a Union Minister in charge of planning. But Niti Aayog is a multi-tiered body. It will still be chaired by the Prime Minister, but there's a governing council of all the chief ministers. So all the chief ministers are now part of the organization. And there's a regional council, like I mentioned earlier. The regional council, see, in many cases, like I'll take an example, in eastern India, the problem is that there's a lot of water, But even then, the agricultural productivity is not much. So you might have heard there was also a scheme of central government which was bringing green revolution to eastern India. So this is a regional approach. So which means that it's not, state is basically an artificial construct. So we just decide to draw a boundary, let us say between UP and Bihar, but there is no geographic or other reason for that boundary to exist there. The problems of, let us say, western Bihar would be very similar to those of eastern UP. So the regional council will look at the region as a whole of any region or wherever there are more than one state involved and will try to solve their problems as a whole. And also Niti Aayog will have experts as special invitees. So a lot of focus is being laid in Niti Aayog on experts, and basically the they are saying specialists should deal with these kind of specialized areas. So in Planning Commission, full-time members were experts in various areas, and they were attached offices like UIDAI, National Institute of Labour, etc. In this case, this is more of just facts, you just need to know this a little bit. So the full-time office will include PM as a chairperson, a vice chairperson, CEO, full-time members, two part-time members, four union ministers as ex-officio members. So we've talked in detail about the functions, but just again, Planning Commission was to formulate and review a five-year plan, target and goal, and advise on specific issues. But Niti Aayog is to develop an agenda or a directional plan of how to foster cooperative federalism between center and states. So again, Planning Commission used to decide state allocation and plan expenditure, but Niti Aayog, apart from doing this, will also provide strategic and technical advice on key issues. This in terms of function, this is the major difference that you need to remember. Okay, some other points as far as Niti Aayog is concerned is that Niti Aayog will focus on the security of the nation as well, the national security. Also, it is going to network with other national and international think tanks. This is again a new feature being added in the Niti Aayog. They say that these days we are in a world of cooperation in terms of the thinking capabilities of everybody in this world. So why not network with other organizations and get the best for the country? This is the thinking behind another thinking of Niti Aayog. Similarly, there are sections of society that are not benefiting enough from economic progress. So economic progress has basically a theory of trickle down, that okay, even if the rich are becoming richer, eventually they will consume the services of the poor or products made by the poor, and eventually the poor will become rich. But still those sections are not benefiting enough from economic progress, because of which the gulf between the rich and the poor is increasing by the day. So Niti Aayog is going to focus specifically on those sections which are not benefiting enough from economic progress. This is not to say that the Planning Commission did not do that. Planning Commission also looked a lot at the leftover sections of society. Now, the Niti Aayog is, like I said, it is an advisory and monitoring role, but the executive functions of exactly formulating a plan for the state, allocating money, that this is your money, this is how you have to spend it, those will not be there in Niti Aayog. So just to sum up, Mr. Arvind Panagriya, who is the first vice chairman of Niti Aayog, he said that we need to push through labor reforms and strengthen the SME segment. SME is the small and medium enterprise segment, which is the backbone of manufacturing. This will take up India several notches in the competition ladder. So this can tell you, this sort of shows you the priorities of Niti Aayog. First of all, labor reforms, which means we are trying to relatively simplify the very complex labor laws that are there in this country right now. Along with that, strengthening the SMEs. So SME again is a sector which has not done as well as it could have in the country. So providing all handholding support to that segment. This is what they feel, and basically manufacturing, which has been a major thrust of the Prime Minister as well, to take up India several notches up in the competition ladder and also bring in prosperity to the people of the nation. So, and also, like I have mentioned earlier, he wants to remold NITI into a policy hub wherein experts of the Aayog itself, also experts from other organizations and countries, will pool together their expertise and bring out a best sort of directional agenda for the country to make India a developed country, so to speak. Thank you for watching. Hope you liked the video. Your comments and suggestions are welcome. Thank you.